Do you have a plan to install IP camera or access point at your house? The PoE Power over Ethernet is an ideal solution to set up the system. The PoE allows us to use single Ethernet cable to send both power and data over the Cat5 or Cat6 Ethernet cable. There's no need for power source at the edge. However, most of the router doesn't support PoE, it's just the non-PoE equipment. In this video, I'm going to discuss how to convert the non-PoE router into PoE compatible device. First thing you need is the power source. This router doesn't supply PoE, so you need to have a power source. Here we got a very typical PoE injector. There are three ports. The input port will take the AC power and convert to the DC PoE power. And here we got two ports. One is the LAN port, it's supposed to connect the router to have the Ethernet accessing. Another one is the PoE port. It will combine both power and data and send to the edge device such like the IP camera and access point. Now let's move to the demonstration world and I will show you how to set up a very simple PoE system. I also will tell you what you need to pay attention while you set up the PoE system. The connection is pretty straightforward. First, let me set this PoE injector next to the router. This is the AC power input. Let's connect the AC power to the PoE injector. Now the PoE injector is getting the power. I will need this short patch cord to link the LAN port to one of the network ports on the router, so we can have the network accessing from the router. This is the cable from the remote edge. And let's connect this cable to the PoE port. So the PoE port will combine both power and data and go through this cable and reach to the edge. Here we got IP camera and access point. I will take the IP camera for example. What I need to do is just connect another end of the cable to the camera. You can see the camera is getting the power, the indicator is on. Now let's move to the mobile phone and check the live video from the IP camera. Now the camera's live. Camera's live now. So the setup is quite simple. You just need one cable and then it goes through the router to the camera. It could be the access point. But there are several things you need to pay attention. The first thing is your edge device needs to support PoE. If you just connect a non-PoE IP camera or your access point doesn't support PoE, it will not work. Because there are four steps in standard PoE system. Before the PoE injector release the power to this Cat5 Cat6 Ethernet cable, you need to classify, verify your edge device. If you detect your edge device, it doesn't support PoE, you will not send the power at all. Here also answer two very important questions. Is it safe to use the PoE? Yes, because the PoE device will verify your edge device. Otherwise, it will not send the power, it just will provide the data. The second thing is about the power budget. You may need to understand what is the maximum power budget your edge device require. For this IP camera, it will need about 6 watts. The access point uses very similar power budget as this IP camera. However, if you are working with this big guy, pan-tilt zoom camera with infrared built-in, it will take about 24 watts. So when you choose the PoE injector, you need to make sure your PoE injector can supply enough power for your edge device. There are three specifications from the PoE standard, IEEE 802.3AF, AT and BT. The latest PoE standard BT can supply up to 90 watts from a single Ethernet port. And our next thing is about a cable. The cable is quite important because the power needs to go through this cable. There are always power loss. If you just use the low quality cable such as the CCA type, it will generate serious power loss. You may don't have enough power at the edge. The next thing is about the speed, network speed. For the camera, 100 megabytes per second will be enough. However, if you are working with the access point, probably you will want to have the 1000 megabytes per second. Bandwidth. So you need to make sure your PoE injector can supply enough speed for your edge device. The last thing is about the surge protection. If there is serious lighting in the area, you may want to add the surge protector both ends, because this is the copper cable. When the lighting hitting to the area, it will spread to the area, and this cable could pick up the surge and transmit both ends. If your edge device is not strong enough, it could be get damaged. In that case, you can add the surge protection at both ends. The surge protector will introduce the lighting and send to the ground. And if you have two edge devices like this one, you have both camera and access point, you want to use single Ethernet cable to send power and data for this edge device, you can reference my another video how to use the single cable to connect camera and access point.